Saxophone players used to play like Jimmy Dorsey, but Charlie Parker would be but deep, just like Slide said, rhythmically, harmonically. I mean, he was bad. Saxophone players used to play like Jimmy Dorsey.
Charlie, I would like to get your opinion on something. I read a very interesting article just a few days ago in Ebony Magazine under the byline of Cab Calloway. Did you read it?
Yes, none of us saw such an article, and I've never read or heard of such a violent, contemptuous thing against musicians of today.
Cab Calloway's article asked, is dope killing our musicians? And made examples of users such as Billie Holiday, Art Blakey, and Fats Navarro, who died a few months earlier. Bird escaped direct mention in the article, but the authorities began a crackdown on the whole jazz scene.
The FBI was very interested in what, because there was a huge amount of money that the mob, the gangsters, were making out of it. society, most of society, looked down on it.
I certainly don't think that a musician necessarily plays better on the influence of any stimulus of any kind. I'm pretty sure you agree with me, don't you?
Well, yes, I'd rather agree with you too, Mr. Man. Well, nobody's fooling themselves. Never. Anymore, anyway. Put it that way. When we're trying to investigate, it should be conducted. It should be done in the right way. Instead of trying to destroy me with his own name.
Other jazz stars such as Thelonious Monk and Bud Powell. Bird's all-important cabaret card, his license to work in New York's clubs, was taken away.
He was a full-time musician. He was also a full-time addict. He knew that world. He knew how to score. He knew how to be safe. That's a full-time life, too. And then he had this third life, living a kind of middle-class suburban dad and husband downtown Manhattan, where everybody, you know, say, hey, here's Charlie, have a beer. He's just a neighbor who always had a smile on his face that everybody loved.
Cab Calloway's article asked, is dope killing our musicians? We'll be right back.
tell you the story about when angry grandpa went to throw a jar at my sister and it hit me in the head. And I guess it's not any better, like, trying to hit a family member with a jar. But still, it was like one of these mason jars. We used to use them, and we would put shit like soup, tomatoes, and, like, I don't know, fucking pears and all kinds of bullshit, homemade sauce and shit like that. We put them in the mason jars and we have them set. Well, we had a two box of them, yucky jars.
And that's the basis of all music.
Here it is.
Night in Tunisia.
Thank you.
A strong, proud people. A nation of many nations, many languages, cultures, and traditions, connected by spirit and body to their families, land, and ancestors. We lived and thrived as a culture and a society for thousands of years. And then, the tall ships came. Colonization is to send settlers to a place and establish political control over it by the separation, dismantling, and eventual assimilation of any pre-existing cultural laws, practices, and traditions into the new colonizing nation's empire. To create this new colony, lands were cleared, stations were built, and the traditional owners of the land were rounded up. In many cases across the country, these acts heartbreakingly separated families, tearing people from their traditional lands and cultural connections, disconnecting people from their very identity and purpose. Many children across consecutive generations were removed from their families due to government policies. These children are known as the Stolen Generations. The physical and mental trauma of these events is unimaginable, but for many, it was real and has created an ongoing legacy of sorrow and trauma to many people across every one of these generations. The effect of past-day events that are present-day impact is now known as intergenerational trauma. The gap that needs to be closed is across these generations. The gap is physical. The gap is emotional. Is different for every person and community in this story. And we are all in this story. As a nation, we are stronger together. A strong, proud people. A nation of many nations, many languages, cultures, and traditions. Connected by spirit and body to their families, land, and ancestors. We lived and thrived as a culture and a society for thousands of years. And then, the tall ships came. Colonization is to send settlers to a place and establish political control over it by the separation, dismantling, and eventual assimilation of any pre-existing cultural laws, practices, and traditions into the new colonizing nation's empire. To create this new colony, lands were cleared, stations were built, and the traditional owners of the land were rounded up. in many cases across the country, these acts heartbreakingly separated families, tearing people from their traditional lands and cultural connections, disconnecting people from their very identity and purpose. Many children across consecutive generations were removed from their families due to government policies. These children are known as the stolen generations. The physical and mental trauma of these events is unimaginable, but for many, it was real and has created an ongoing legacy of sorrow and trauma to many people across every one of these generations. The effect of past day events that are present day impact is now known.
Here it is, night Tunisia.
Here it is. Night Tunisia.
Thank you.
Charlie Parker. I said, that's it. That's it. That's it.
Only a dance. there is an indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything. I feel it, though I do not see it. It is this unseen power which makes itself felt and yet defies all proof, because it is so unlike all that I perceive through my senses. It transcends the senses, but it is possible to reason out the existence of God to a limited extent. Even in ordinary affairs, we know that people do not know who rules or why and how he rules. And yet, they know that there is a power that certainly rules. In my tour last year in Mysore, I met many poor villagers, and I found upon inquiry that they did not know who ruled Mysore. They simply said, some god ruled it. If the knowledge of these poor people was so limited about their ruler, I, who am infinitely lesser in respect to God than they to their ruler, need not be surprised if I do not realize the presence of God, the King of Kings. Nevertheless, I do feel, as the poor villagers felt about my soul, that there is orderliness in the universe. There is an unalterable law governing everything and every being that exists or lives. It is not a blind law, for no blind law can govern the conduct of living beings. And thanks to the marvelous researches of Sir J.C. Bowes, it can now be proved that even matter is life. That law, then, which governs all life, is God. Law and the lawgiver are one. I may not deny the law or the lawgiver because I know so little about it or him. Just as my denial or ignorance of the existence of an earthly power will avail me nothing, even so, my denial of God and his law will not liberate me from its operation. Whereas humble and mute acceptance of divine authority makes life journey easier, even as the acceptance of earthly rule makes life I do dimly perceive that while everything around me is ever changing, ever dying, there is underlying all that change a living power that is changeless, that holds all together, that creates, dissolves, and recreates. There is an indefinable There is an indefinable That informing power of spirit is God. Indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything. I feel it, though I do not see it. It is this unseen power which makes itself felt and yet defies all proof, because it is so unlike all that I perceive through my senses. It transcends the senses, but it is possible to reason out the existence of God to a limited extent. Even in ordinary affairs, we know that people do not know who rules or why and how he rules. And yet, they know that there is a power that certainly rules. In my tour last year in Mysore, I met many poor villagers, and I found upon inquiry that they did not know. That informing power of spirit is God.
Wright Brothers Flyer, lifted from level group. muscles will never be as strong as birds. Because humans' arm muscles will never be as strong as birds. Because humans' arm muscles will never be as strong as birds. Because humans' arm muscles will never be as strong as birds. Because humans' arm muscles will never be as strong as birds. Humans often dreamed of being able to fly, and made many variations of mechanical ways to fly like birds. All of these attempts were failures, because humans' arm muscles will never be as strong as birds. The Chinese were the first to achieve flight. They discovered that the kite could fly back around 400 BC. They made many beautiful and colorful kites that were used in both fun and for religious ceremonies. In the 1840s, Leonardo da Vinci did many flight studies. He had more than 100 drawings and theories. Arthur and De Haerlem was actually based on an idea he had for a human flying machine called the ornithon. In 1783, a sheep, a rooster, and duck took flight for the first hot air balloon passengers, invented by Joseph Michaels and Jacques and Jean Pontesi. They lit a fire under a silver bag to make hot air to the first manned flight was on November 21st, 1783. Of course, nowadays, hot air balloons vary in size, shape, and color, and are seen all over the world. From 1799 to the 1850s, George Cable made the discovery of a way that man could fly as well. He designed many different versions of gliders that were controlled by movements of bodies. Over 50 years, he made many pieces of gliders. He designed a tail for the gliders to help stabilize it. He tried a guy made design to add strength to the glider. He also
But now it has happened. No use in talking. The silence between me and you has never had meaning. It was. Love it. That was all that was asked. But now it has happened. No words for the foretime. The desperation has made me the same, has made me another. Who looks at the shape of a fish grow giant on the side of his bowl? Who walks on the terrace observing foliage from above? Who hears the snapping of plastic that wraps like cellophane bare branches of climbers? You don't know. And I who descend the stairs neither. I am the same. I am another. But now it has happened. No use in talking. The silence between me and you has never had meaning. It was. Love it. That was all it was asked. But now it has happened. No words for the foretime. The desperation has made me the same, has made me another. Who looks at the shape of a fish grow giant on the side of his bowl? Who walks on the terrace observing foliage from above? Who hears the snapping of plastic that wraps like cellophane bare branches of climbers? You don't know. And I who descend the stairs neither. I am the same. I am another.
Thank you.
Love it. That was all it was asked. But now it has happened. No words for the foretime. The desperation has made me the same. It's made me another. Who looks at the shape of a fish grow giant on the side of his fold? Who walks on the terrace observing foliage from above? Who hears the snapping of plastic that wraps like cellophane where it branches of climbers? You don't know. And I who descend the stairs, neither. I am the same. I am another. But now it has happened. No use in talking. The silence between me and you has never had meaning. It was. Love it. That was all it was asked. But now it has happened. No words for the foretime. The desperation has made me the same. It made me another. Who looks at the shape of a fish grow giant on the side of his bowl? Who walks on the terrace observing foliage from above? Who hears the snapping of plastic that wraps like cellophane where it branches of climbers? You don't know. And I who descend the stairs tonight. I am the same. No use in talking. The silence between me and you has never had meaning. It was. Love it. That was all it was asked. But now it has happened. No words for the foretime. The desperation has made me the same. It's made me another. Who looks at the shape of a fish grow giant on the side of his bowl? Who walks on the terrace observing foliage from above? Who hears the snapping of plastic that wraps like cellophane bare branches of climbers? You don't know. And I who descend the stairs, neither. I am the same. I am another.